that the private gatherings and social gatherings are the reason for these spikes. The workplace are the reason for the spikes, and travel is the work is the reason for these spikes. Yet these are the places that keep getting pounded. They opened, they closed. They opened, they closed. They tried everything they could. Look, San Marcos Brewery, curbside, to-go parking only. They tried that. It worked for about 12 seconds. Now, Kim, follow me over here and take a look at this. This is just sad, and I'm here by myself, so it's weird. The whole place is dark. They actually have been closed for about 2 weeks. They happened to be inside today when we were there. But here was the original sign. It just said, we'll be back to business. Not today, but please come back. Well, guess what? That's been updated to our friends. The brewery has closed operations due to the corona. We thank you for all the support throughout these years, 27 years of good. It was a good long run, and we wish you well. Cheers. And that's dated November 17th, so that was the last day that I guess they had the doors open. And we talked to the owner earlier today. One of them actually ended up going on camera. We'll share that with you coming up tonight at 10. But it is a very emotional day, a very, very tough day for these folks. We did manage to talk to the mayor of San Marcos, who gets phone calls every single day from another business owner that is worried about closing or actually is closing. And clearly the local politicians, the local leaders here in San Diego County want some kind of local control so that centralized one-man rule up in Sacramento doesn't continue going. We've talked about it for months, but this continues to be the trend, and the culture of closing continues to be the pattern. So here's the mayor of San Marcos earlier today talking about the closing of the first brew pub, by the way, kind of buried the lead, the first brew pub in North County is going away forever. Listen to the mayor.
It makes me sick that after 27 years, everything that they've put into this business, the families have grown up, the kids have grown up with it, with this as part of their family, and now it's gone. Shut its door. All because government stood in the way of them being able to stay open and thrive. I've seen so many people just rally to the occasion. Go outside, go back inside, go back outside. But we're at the point where that's just no longer going to work. And if we close down everything in, for an indefinite period of time, even 3 weeks, that is going to be the end of many of these businesses. And we are just paving the way for corporations to come in and gobble up these small businesses.
Of course, she is referring to the possibility, the hinting out of Sacramento that we could be locked down completely here in San Diego going into the most important 3 weeks of the holidays, starting with Hanukkah, then Christmas, then Kwanzaa, then New Year's, right? And everything's going to be shut down. Once again, if you want to follow the science, you want to talk about following the science doesn't say close these places down. It says find those private parties. Crack down on the workplaces and control the travel. I mean, 6 million people flew on Thanksgiving. What's that? What's going to happen there? I mean, we know what's going to happen there. It's going to spread. It's flying around the world. So, quite honestly, the government leaders, they call themselves leaders, are going after the wrong people to try to stop the spread, and they're crushing businesses along the way. Like the mayor said, a lot of big corporations still have a lot of money. Jeff Bezos is going to come in and buy California before you know it, and he's going to own the whole place because he's the only one out there making money, because he's the only one, one of the only ones that isn't a victim of the culture of closing. Of course, if you're on the internet, you are safe, and they've been doing better than ever. Record profits on the internet. I stand in front of an empty building, the first brew pub in San Marcos. It's a sad world we're living in right now, you guys. And once again, just end by saying, help out your local business if you can. We're going into the holiday season. There's a month left. Today is December 2nd. There's a month left of 2020. We want to get out of this year. We want to get to 2021 and put this behind us. But in the meantime, we need to help our neighbors as much as we can. And that means digging deep into your pockets, as I say, and also into your hearts, because this could actually be saving a family's life, the family that owns these businesses. So we'll have a wrap-up for you coming up tonight at 10 o'clock, and we're going to let you hear from Dave, who was the original founding father of San Marcos Brewery, and we're going to let you hear in his own words a couple of guys who came up to the bar and talked to him one day, and what those guys ended up doing with craft beer here in San Diego. It's crazy. It was a launching pad for a lot of people right here in San Marcos, and it is no longer. So it's tough. It's a tough day for a lot of people out here in San Marcos, particularly the guys who own this place after 27 years. So we'll wrap up. See you tonight at 10, somewhere out here.
All right, Dan, I want to reiterate something really important. We are getting close. was, or the holidays, shopping small.